Guys, this is Down Phoenix, and this is actually a video being done in the living room because I figured it'd be the best spot to do this. But I got a new Nintendo cartridge. This is Super Games 340-in-1. This claims to have 340 unique games. As you see on the cover, we have games like Mario and Tournament Fighter and Contra and the one that's the Japanese font supposed to be like the Kunio-kun games and so on. So this will be a really good treat. Now, some of you may be aware of this little bad boy right here, except a lot of you probably seen it in red. That's the most common variation. But I was able to get a classic gray version of it to look, you know, to blend into my actual Nintendo card collection. So we've got the both of these here. I'm not going to really show this off. There's plenty of YouTubers that have done it. For example, Black Metal Gamer did a good little video showing you all the games on here. So go check that out. Today, I'm going to show you this one. I'm going to show you what this one has. So if you're interested in getting the list of games, that's what we're getting to right now. Okay, so this is what you get when you first get into the game here. You get all these things. Now, if you're not familiar with the NES library, there are only three actual Contra games. So I don't know why they have Contra 6, 7, and 8. And they decided, fuck 4 and 5. Nobody liked them anyway. Because they didn't exist. That's why nobody liked them. So we're just going to go through the list here, guys. I'm just going to make just minor commentary to go through the list here. So this is the first page of games, you know. And then we'll kind of discuss some of them. But look at that Ninja Gaiden. I never played the Ninja Gaiden games before. Just gonna pause for a little bit to give you guys all a chance to look at the game library. What happened to Bruce Lee 1? Mario 10, Mario 12, Mario 14. Oh man, this one's probably filled with to the brim with freaking Chinese ROM hacks. Okay. Some legit games there. Kind of weird how they have things all randomly ordered. Why not have the Mega Man games grouped together, for example? Exit X's? What kind of freaking name for a game is that? Fruit Pig? Ah, oh, jeez, man. We're definitely in ROM hack territory for sure. I don't know if you guys can hear the little hum. There's like a little hum whenever my Nintendo is plugged in. I think it may just be bad video cable or something. Or audio cable, I suppose, since video doesn't make sound, supposedly, so yeah. Okay, so we're almost through the list here. Shows about 15 games per page, it looks like, something like that. Okay. Through, man. Utmost Warfare. Ooh. Sounds like some good games here. Okay. It's kind of weird because this one has like a mix of actual games and ones that obviously don't exist or are ROM hacks. So that's really weird. It's just interesting. And then apparently there's just bowling. So, yeah, this will be interesting to see what all we've got here. Water Pip? What kind of freaking names are these? That doesn't make sense, man. Plus, I'm not even sure if there's really... Because there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11... Oh, there's 16 games per page. That's kind of weird. Okay. I was like, well, how are we getting to where we only have 4 games left on this one? Okay. So that's the full list of games, and then if you head over, you go back to that. Now, here's what's really interesting. I don't really understand what's going on here. Let's say you want to play Contra 1. I mean, everybody wants to play Contra 1. That's one of the reasons why they put it in the beginning of the cart. You hit that, and it goes into this separate thing that says 12-1. So how many fucking games is this? Now we have Contras 4 and 5, finally. So, in case you were wondering where those were. So, let's go into Contra 1. Everybody knows that one. Contra 1, bitches. Okay, sorry about the glare. I don't have a capture card set up where I can record my NES with an RGB SCART cable, so I guess I failed YouTube. But, I mean, I really want to have something like that. I just don't have that set up right now. It really does take a lot of know-how to really do something like that effectively. But, you know, we could do Contra just fine. It seems like it plays like the real game. My A button gets stuck on this controller. But this is better than the other controller I was using where the diagonal doesn't seem to work at all. So I can't do this in Contra, which I figure, well, I'll get a thing where I just have to really slam the A button to play Contra. That is my official excuse for why I didn't, why I died after grabbing that power-up, is because my A button is stuck. I mean, you guys have to realize this controller is probably 30 plus years old, so, I mean, everybody, well, 30 plus, I guess. I mean, NES is just turning 30, so it's like probably 25 plus years old, I guess is what I'm trying to say. So, yeah, let's go ahead and see what else we've got here. So, what's this other Contra stuff, of course? Now, Contra 30P, I think that's actually like an automatic 30-player code, if I'm not mistaken. Let's find out here. Yes, there you go. You don't have to put the code anymore. So if you really love Contra, you might want to get this cartridge. You can just start the Contra 30P, and then you automatically got the 30 lives, if you so choose. Makes me wonder what's up with these other Contra variations and why I go straight to this list. So, let's see. What's a suit gun? Let's check that out. I'm not sure what that is. I'm assuming it's probably just a ROM hack of Contra. Probably a different character suit or something. Oh, apparently they also have hacked versions. So if you want to start with the machine gun at the beginning of the game, play a suit gun. Okay. And then I assume that loop gun and shotgun are referring to the flamethrower and the shotgun. Let's go ahead and check them out. Yep, that's loop gun for you. Hey, I wonder, if you die, do you start again with the same gun? Holy shit, you do! So just help me play shotgun and you'll just win Contra all the time. That's awesome. Okay, so let's see what Contra 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and 8 are. And they're all in the same... This is not Super C, people. Why is this one Contra 2? Oh, Stage 2! Okay. Ha! It also includes a level skip code. That is awesome. That is freaking sweet. Dude, I already love this cartridge. I mean, yeah, a lot of these games are probably bullshit, but dude, I love Contra. And being able to play it in these different variations like this, that's just... awesome, man. No Game Genie codes or nothing needed. So if you love some Contra and you want, like, some different ways to play it, you know, this is a good cart to get for sure. I guess that's why they made it the number one game on this cart, because they really are pushing the Contra on this one. Okay, so that makes me really wonder what Contra 2, 3, 6, 7, and 8 are in this cart. But let's check out 2. It better be motherfucking Super C. What the hell? What is this? It's the same freaking menu, but for Super C. Awesome, dude. Except this is like the Japanese version? Not that it freaking matters. You just shoot shit in this game. It's But yeah, some motherfucking Super C. I don't remember if you are supposed to start with the machine gun in Super C. I guess you are. Well, maybe not. That was clearly the power-up for it, so I don't know. Maybe this is not the exact Super C, but hey... It's got a bunch of variations of it, at least. I guess if you want to play something other than the legit one. Yeah, Super C is a nice little game. It doesn't get the respect it deserves. So, yeah, we'll check out some of the other variations. Okay, so this one's with the shotgun, just like we expect, guys. Alright. Holy crap! Now this is the way to play some freaking Super C, man! You can probably actually beat the game like this, maybe, for once! This is just awesome, dude! Okay, so this is apparently the Rapid Sword gun. I'm not really familiar with that weapon. I think it is one of the new weapons that they had, but I have no idea what they mean by that. Let's see what weapon they're talking about here. Oh, okay, so it's the flamethrower, because they changed the flamethrower in Super C to something like this. Okay, I gotcha. Well, that's kind of cool, I suppose. So, another gun hack mod. And then, of course, you get the 30 live ones. If you just want regular 30 lives, spread, flame, you know, the different gun power-ups like you see up there. And then these are the stage skips that you can do. I'm not sure what Contra 3C is. Let's just check it out here. Area 3, I'm guessing. Okay. But I'm not sure what the C versus the A was, because there was A and C. Oh, okay. So this is like one where you can just start with the power-up already. Yep. Indeed. I already love this cartridge, man. And I just played two games off of it. But I have a feeling that a lot of these games will probably be duds, too, so... That's probably why they really push these ones. Alright, so let's check out Contra 3. I'm sure it's gotta be Contra Force. Yep, I kind of expected that. So everybody's familiar with Contra Force, I'm sure. Let's go ahead and play, Burns, I guess. I don't really know the difference between these people. I know this game's a lot different from an actual Contra game. Like, apparently... It wasn't even Contra-like at all. They kind of, like, added crap to it. And for some reason, you can't diagonally fire in this one. That's really a strange choice. Or at least I can't diagonally down. I don't know why I can't in this one. I'm using the same D-pad that's not having that issue, so I don't know. Maybe I'm just making stuff up or something. Okay, whatever. Contra Force. Everybody knows Contra Force. But this one doesn't have a billion ROM variations. It's just... plain old Contra Force. Alright, so we're going to check out Contra 6. Super Contra 6, that is. We'll see what this one's all about. Okay, it's another Contra Force one, but if you want to play with actual characters like Rambo, which looks more like Hugh Jackman, you could do that. You also have Ryu and Guile, apparently, a couple of Street Fighter characters making their debut here. So it's just a graphical hack of Contra Force. This is apparently a Contra game. I've never heard of it. 50 Rest? Holy crap, this is an actual hack of Contra. Yes. But those graphics look really familiar. Holy crap, this is a bad one, dude. Look at how terrible that screen flicker is. Plus, it has a typical Japanese ROM hack music, man, that everybody knows. It sounds like fucking diarrhea to the ears. Yep, Contra 7. Oh, jeez. Well, how about Contra 8? So Contra 4 and 5 must have been really bad ROM hacks if they didn't even include those. They're like, no, fuck that. You can buy our standards, they suck. Okay, this one's the same... title screens, the other just didn't have a copyright date. It looks like it's the same exact game, to me at least. Oh, except I have this now, I guess? So it's just a variation of that one, I suppose? Yeah, it's the exact same music and everything. Like, who would play this? Just listen to the music. What the hell is this? Alright, so when you're all contra'd out, what else does this cartridge include? Well, we've already seen the list of games here. But I do want to check out some of the ones that just don't make sense, like RoboCop 4. There was definitely not a fourth RoboCop game on the NES, so let's see what this is about. At least I didn't think there was. Apparently it was 1992 on it. It's a Blake production. No, this is a ROM hack. This has to be. But this is based on RoboCop 3, if I'm not mistaken. Yeah, this is a RoboCop 3 game. Okay. Apparently, RoboCop 3 is actually the best of the NES games, if you could believe that, which... That's what I've heard, at least from some people. I don't know, I think I prefer the original myself. But this game's got really wonky, like, physics and crap like that. And plus, what's up with that guy, like, just ducking randomly? I don't know, that's stupid. And he's still firing off screen, that's crazy. Now, we know that there's two Tiny Toon games. Two Tiny Toon games. There was not a Tiny Toon 3, so this one is definitely a ROM hack. Tiny Toon 3 Crazy Castle. This is Bugs Bunny Crazy Castle. Why is it Tiny... Really now? Why did they do that? That's stupid. I don't think I've ever played this one, actually. I have no idea what this game's about. Apparently, you can push stuff. Okay, whatever. Let's move on. I know there's not a Double Dragon 4. There's no way that that exists. Blank proudly presents. They're not even... They know their products are crap. That's why they don't put their names on it. Oh, it looks like that guy. It looks like PewDiePie, kind of. If he was actually semi-badass. Ready to rub... Oh, okay, I know what this is. This is like that, There actually was a Double Dragon 4 that they were making, I think, or something. Or actually, no, this isn't an actual Double Dragon 4. This is like Target Renegade or some nonsense, I think. I don't know which one this is, dude. I'm going to have to find out for sure. I'm pretty sure it's Renegade, though. But, yeah, this is Double Dragon 4. The other Double Dragons are here, too, apparently. But anyways, why ever use anything besides a kick? Because it's got the best reach. The game, there's like not any benefit to using the punch at all. Not like fast or anything. Yeah, this is dumb. Okay, I'm not familiar with an Adventure Island 4. But, yeah, I'm not going to check out everyone. Like, oh, I never heard of that one. That doesn't make sense. Let's check out Chip and Dale 3. We know that's not a real game. So let's see what that's about. They actually put a little bit of effort into the title screen, sort of. Destroy enemies, underground artillery. Has got nothing to do with it. Oh, my God. I think this is like freaking Commando or not Commando, it's Heavy Barrel. It's what this is. Oh shoot, man. What the hell are these little grenade looking things? Oh shit, well. It's a ROM hack of Heavy Barrel, that's all this is. And they didn't make a Chip and Dale 3, don't be fooled, people. But I just don't understand why Heavy Barrel. I mean, I would get it if they did, like, a ripoff of, say, like, DuckTales or some other platforming game, but Heavy Barrel? Really? Alright, Hot Blood Wrestle. Never heard of these games. I wonder if they're Japanese games. 1993? Oh, shit, it's a Kunio-kun game. Hells yeah. It's in Japanese, but you know what? Let's try it. Let's just play it. Where's, I'll pick that one, whatever. So I take a second. Oh, it's a name entry. Okay. I have no idea what I'm selecting. Let's just do it. Okay, so this is a Kunio-kun game where you can... It's like a fighting game, apparently. I guess, we'll just play our good old buddy Alex there. I guess we'll find him whenever. Oh, it's an actual wrestling game. Okay. I'll go ahead and put the title of the actual game. I'm apparently playing as this other guy. But it looks like it's similar in regards. Holy crap, the sprite flicker is bad. It makes you wonder if that's actually how it's supposed to be. I'm going to have to find what this game is on a... like a emulator or something like that. See what it's actually supposed to look like. Because this one's got terrible sprite flicker, dude. But you know what? I love the Kuniyaku games. They have some awesome gameplay and graphics, man. They're definitely underrated for sure. Like, we didn't get enough of those in the U.S. All we got, as far as I remember, is... We got River City Ransom, of course. Everybody loves that game. And we also got Super Dodgeball. I don't know if we got any others, at least for the NES. Oh, wait, no, we got Crash and the Street Boys Challenge or whatever, too. Whatever. Okay, so I'm sure these other Hot Blood games are probably the same series. So let's check it out here. Okay, so this one's actually Japanese River City Ransom. I mean, River City Ransom is a beat-up. You don't really need the dialogue. The Japanese one, you actually wear a Japanese uniform, like a school uniform, instead of, look that we're used to. But otherwise, it's pretty much the same exact game. This is how it's supposed to be. Good times. Oh, yeah, they had a soccer one, too. So the soccer one, that's the Kuniyakun soccer game. Hot Blood March, I'm not sure what that is. Maybe they had four different ones on here. I think I know what this one is. Okay, so this is that Crash in the Street Boy Challenge. That could have actually been in the Retro Olympics. I didn't even think about that. Or I think it's that one. I don't know. Seems similar-ish. But, yeah. You get a few Kuniyakun games, so that's really good. Unfortunately, they're all the Japanese equivalent ones, but it is what it is. I mean, when you get this cartridge for as cheap as I did, you don't really have a right to complain. Got Ninja Turtles 1, Ninja Turtles 4, I'm sure that's original, and Tournament Fighters. Let's just check this one out. Just to be sure. Yep, Tournament Fighter. Okay. I guess we'll check it out for a little bit. This game goes for a crazy amount of money. It's weird because, like, this is not a very good game. But, I know it's highly sought out by collectors because it's just so rare. But imagine, like, if you were back in the freaking, man, I don't know how to play this game at all. This game is terrible. It really is. Ha, whatever. But, yeah, this game's highly sought after, but back in the day, if you were asking for your parents, hey, give me Tournament Fighters, and they got you the NES cart, and you had, like, a Super Nintendo or Sega, yeah, you were too happy with them. That didn't happen to me personally, but... I'm just saying that you would not have been very happy if that actually happened to you, I'm sure. I have no idea. Okay, I guess you can do an uppercut. Yep. And look how tiny bit of damage it did. Like, this fighting game takes forever to play, man. That's the thing with NES fighting games. There wasn't very many of them, but the ones that they had, like, you always did a tiny-ass amount of damage unless you pull off some crappy move like that, and then it does, like, 50 billion points of damage, you know, in comparison. Like, what the hell, dude? He's just constantly biting my head. Wait, is that power-ups you're giving him? What is... I have no idea how to get that. Nah, this game sucks. Mortal Kombat 4. We know that there wasn't even a Mortal Kombat 1. So apparently there's a Mortal Kombat 4, which consists of... not really that many characters. A palette swaps variety of, like, about six different characters of Mortal Kombat. So, yeah, might as well play Green Sub-Zero, I suppose. And that music is just awful. Holy crap, that's diarrhea. Holy shit! You see him fly, dude? Hey, at least it's got blood. Oh, jeez, dude. Look how tiny damage is. Apparently that's Nightwolf I'm fighting against. That looks more like Shao Kahn, bitch. And apparently Liu Kang is a sprite of freaking Green Sub-Zero. How would you ever know what character you're playing as? Unless you actually played every individual character. And even then, you don't know if it's actually legit. And the collision detection is just terrible, man. Like, I get it, 360 games, this is technically a game. Not an official one, but it is a game. But it just seemed like an excuse to have a blood splatter effect in a video game on the NES cartridge. Seems like it's all it is, dude. Apparently, Liu Kang... Oh yeah, he does have a fireball move. I forgot about that. But yeah, fireball him to death. Seems like the legit way to win. He got hit even though he jumped over it. Awesome. Well, I know how to win this one. He still... Oh, jeez. This is the best ROM hack yet and worst at the same time. Alright. I mean, some of these seem like they're probably obvious. Like, there's a Street Fighter one. Okay, this is a Street Fighter ROM hack. Let's see, apparently there's Chun-Li, darker-looking Chun-Li. So it says 12 peoples, but there's only 6 again. I wonder if it's a limitation of the NES that only displays 6 face portraits on the same screen. We know that this is a different variation of Chun-Li, so let's see if it's actually a different character. It says Chun-Li still. And Ryu's nose looks broken. And this Chun-Li, so why are they at false advertise it as 12 peoples? Two fireballs, that's it! Or maybe hitting a 3, I don't know. Apparently Chun-Li has a tail and is green in this one. Oh, jeez, and that sprite flicker was just terrible, dude. That was some awful-ass sprite flicker. Why would somebody play that? Now, Mighty Final Fight, hopefully it's a good version of it. The story start. I'm a little worried about this one now. It didn't have the actual Capcom logo. This is not good. Okay. I can't skip this story. It looks like a Mighty Final Fight otherwise. It still makes me wonder why they edited out the Capcom logo. Like, was Capcom after whoever made this version? Like, okay, we know we can't stop you from stealing our game, technically, but we want you to stop using our name. And they're like, okay, we'll just put Blank Presents on there instead. But yeah, otherwise, it's Mighty Final Fight, which is a pretty nice little game. This one's a pricey one, too, so if you're looking to save some money, not pay a couple $100 for a single NES cartridge, and I guess you can get this one for a lot cheaper. As long as you don't really need that Capcom logo, then you're all set. Alright, there's Kaioku Tiger. I'm not sure what that is. Never even heard of it. Holy crap! What is up with the freaking flicker in this game? I think this is another game. I can't remember what it is. I think this game might actually be intended to play in 3D. Look at how terrible the movement and shit is. And at the beginning of the screen, I think this was actually meant to play with 3D glasses. I don't know, maybe it's just a really terrible ROM hack or something. That they just, they couldn't get things right or something, I don't know. But yeah, it's a crappy game. And by the way, I'll edit some stuff in as I find out what these games are and stuff like that. I'll make sure to let you guys know. There's Gulf War. I've never heard of a Gulf War video game for the NES, so let's see what that one's about. Gulf War 1990. Oh, it's just Silkworm. Okay, well, I call it Gulf War then. That doesn't make sense. Heat-seeking missile, okay. But yeah, I guess this is Silkworm. I don't think I ever played Silkworm. I mean, I was familiar with it, like, from Nintendo Power and shit, but... I mean, yeah, I just don't... This one just does not... I don't think I ever played it. So my first cherry with this game being popped is a Japanese ROM hack cartridge. Yay. Or Japanese-Chinese, rather. The Japanese actually made this game in comparison, so... Why can't I destroy that one? Holy crap, it morphs! It makes me wonder about this final mission... Oh, shit. It's actual Tiny Toons. Okay. We know that's Konami! I was gonna say, this makes me wonder about the actual final mission game. Was there an actual final mission game? I'm sure there probably was, but I just don't remember. Looks official enough. Oh, okay, this game goes by a different name. But yeah, this is an actual game. It's like Scat or Scar or something like that. Yeah, I'll just put the title below. I mean, in case you don't know for sure what it is. Okay, so this is Power Ranger right here. I don't know why my recording stopped, but... apparently there's a lot of story here. We just want to play as some fucking Power Rangers, guys. That's... Yeah, let's play as Trina or whatever. Okay, this is really freaking funky. I don't remember them shooting guns in the show that often. I mean, yeah, I guess they did a little bit. They had the little phaser things or whatever, but... I don't know. Actually, I don't remember. It's been such a long time since I watched the show. I have no freaking clue. But I don't know. This is an actual game. It's just really weird. It's weird that we never got it in the U.S. Because, I mean, Power Ranger Mania was just, like, sweeping the nation around this time. Okay, and this is the last page that we're going to check out with this particular video here. I got Bubble Bobble 2. That's kind of a rare game. Darkwing Duck, Guerrilla Warfare, Dead Fox, never heard of it. Let's check it out and see what Dead Fox is. Okay, it looks like it's going to be a ROM hack. Oh, I think this is Codename Viper. Yeah, it's the Japanese version of Codename Viper. So I guess we don't need the story. Okay. You can play this one instead. Yep. Codename Viper. It's kind of a weird little game. It's like a sort of like a Rolling Thunder type game. So, you know, if you like Rolling Thunder and you want to play more games like that, then check this one out. Alright, everybody's familiar with Power Blade, POW, Jungle Book, Airwolf, Alien 3, Superman, Bruce Lee 2. I'm not familiar with the Bruce Lee 2. Like I said earlier, so let's check it out. This might be a Japanese-only game, I'm thinking. Okay, yep. Okay, I think this is a game that we actually have in the U.S., but it has no Bruce Lee name to it. I forget what it's called. If I find out what it is, I'll let you guys know for sure on the screen below. Otherwise, you can just comment what it is. Seems like it plays okay, though. It's kind of like, you know what? This reminds me a lot of Bad Dudes. So I wonder if this is like a sequel to Bad Dudes or something. Yeah, this has a lot of similar gameplay. Banana Prince is apparently a game on this cartridge. It's a real game? I've never heard of this game. What's up with Steinmax? What? the hell is this game, man? Okay, I can't jump, apparently. Get my freaking button. It's, like, really touchy. So, yeah, I think this is a real game. I had no clue that this game even existed. I didn't know Banana Prince was a thing. Look how fast that timer counts down. Holy crap. If you want to kill broccoli, this game has you killing broccoli, so that's always nice. Everybody loves killing broccoli. But the question is, what... This is a freaking German game. This is really surprising. I was not expecting a German variant of a game on this cartridge. Why? So we've got Saint. I'm not sure what Saint is. So let's check it out. Got some stars. Oh, okay. I think I know what this might be. Okay. This is based on that anime. Saint Seiya, I think is what it's called. Oh, I could choose the people, or... I have no idea. This is not a talking game, is it? This is... I don't know what I'm doing here. Okay. Yeah, this is Saint Seiya. For sure, I can tell. Yeah, this is a Japanese-only game, too, like... We had no idea this thing even existed back then, so, that's kind of weird. But for some reason, my character just zoomed right into that pit. Like, the jumping is super touchy here. So this would not have been a game we would have enjoyed. And for some reason, the life bar just randomly drops a random amount. And doesn't make a lot of sense, so apparently we can go up here. Okay, yeah. But yeah, Saint Seiya. Back on the Famicom. Rockin' Cats, I don't... Oh, shoot, yeah, I know what this game is. Okay, never mind. Yeah, this is an actual game. Yeah. Yeah, this is a game that we got. It's actually a pretty obscure one, if I'm not mistaken. Alright, and let's check out Juki. Might as well. Asmic. 1988 Sega. Holy shit, I think I know what this is. It's motherfucking Altered Beast. Yes. We never got this in the US, but yeah, they actually made a version of Altered Beast for the NES, or well, the Famicom, what they call it in Japan, but yes. This is the same game. They actually have this on the Master System as well, but, like, for whatever reason, this is actually a good version of Altered Beast. So that's sweet. It looks like shit. I mean, this is, like, a terrible-looking version of Altered Beast, but it is very legit gameplay-wise. And the music ain't too bad. But yeah, Altered Beast. You got this on this cartridge. Suck it, winged creature. Okay, yeah, so you have to turn into the boss eventually, brah. Ah, crap. Very touchy controls in this one, dude. But yeah, Altered Beast, motherfuckers. And I think that'll be a wrap for this part of the cartridge. We're going to explore more games in another episode. You guys can go back to the beginning episode if you just want to see a list of games that it includes. And then check out the future parts if you want to see what some of these other variations of these games and whatnot are. But till then, Dal Phoenix out.